The important result from this experiment is really bringing quantum imaging to the wide field realm, which means that you can use just like a normal camera, like a normal camera that you use on the microscope or on your phone.
Our technique provides an alternative where in low levels of light, where you will have a lot of noise, you can reduce that noise. And you for sure will not damage your sample.
So sensitivity really has to do with noise. If you have more noise in your measurement, then the amount of stuff that you can see is smaller, right? I mean, if the background in your measurement is really noisy, then the amount of sample you can see is less. In the end, lets us, you know, see more details in the sample itself.
First, we demonstrated that interference patterns are enhanced by the quantum effect, by two photons. Later, we showed that it's possible to get noise reduction in low levels of light for two kinds of samples, birefringent ones that we artificially generate, and we did this. We also analyzed transparent samples, real proteins, protein A deposit in silica substrates. The quantum microscope that we use in QMIC counts not single photons but coincidences. Any event that the camera registers as a single photon in post-processing is rejected, because all the useful information for the quantum enhanced measurement requires two photons to be detected.
So this is the sample that we measured. These are some spots of protein A, which is a standard diagnostic solution. It was made in-house, and there were some spots of protein spotted onto these glass slides. So then we mount these samples on the sample holder here, which is then placed inside the microscope.
If you have a classical system that it's taking an image of a flat surface through the interference method, you at very low levels of light, you will see, instead of a flat image, you will see some level of noise, right? So it's not blurry, but it's a randomness in the level of the data. When you do the same but with quantum light, like in our system, you will reduce the level of noise, this randomness, so you can get better information about sharp edges, about transitions from face to face, which at the end is essential for recognizing concentration, recognizing depth, height of the samples.
We've made it more practical, I would say. We've taken this technique that is relatively well known by now, and we've integrated it into a wide field of view, a large field of view. Like, you can look at an image at a single time without having to scan over each individual pixel to reconstruct an image.
I would expect that our prototype would eventually evolve to a practical device, in a few years maybe, and be able to be transported and be used in hospitals probably, or being used in industry. Within QMIC, there are a lot of partners. There is people working in the development of the new source, which is Fraunhofer Institute and the Institute of Quantum Optics in Vienna. We also have people working in the new cameras that will be needed for the project, which is MPD and PolyMe in Italy. And finally, we also have people working in another generation of imaging based on Hongo-Mandel effects, which is University of Glasgow. We also have people in industry, which is size.
The next steps in the short term are to pack this the microscope and the camera into a box, and we will go to our partners at Fraunhofer Institute in Jena, and we will take some measurements with their entangled photon source, which the entangled photon source has a shorter wavelength, which has two advantages. It gives you a higher efficiency in detection, so it means that the measurement can be done much faster, And because the wavelength is shorter, it also gives you a better resolution in phase. So it means that the features that we can see in samples are smaller. In my undergraduate studies, I worked with some quantum imaging setups too, and it was really interesting, but these experimental setups were really slow, they were painstaking to align, they were just a hassle to work with. And then I was doing an internship at ICFO some years ago, and I came across this camera by Microphoton Devices, and the first time I worked with it, I was amazed, because this was a revolution to me. This, you could suddenly do these things that were slow and painstaking, you could do them efficiently and quickly. And this is why I became interested in this project.